told you that you couldn't do it cause you're washed up. Ain't like them bad girls said you should get your sauce up. But I got this plan and you might not understand. I'ma go hard as I can and I'm gonna be the boss of it. Just watch me do this, put no limits, only swag on it. Walk right up to the front where I belong and brand.
Hi there, my fellow family. My family, how are you doing? So, peep this out. I know I took a little break. I've really been focusing on getting the sitting area studio together, the stage, however, whatever, the platform, whatever you want to call it, the background and everything. We're getting it together, the set. There you go. Getting the set together. So, with all of the homework in school and then my parently duties, because y'all know I'm a mother of three, right? Yeah, I broke a nail today. OMG, let me tell you, I broke a nail. Ain't been able to get them fixed because I fix them myself, but I've been ripping and running. I ain't been able to sit down today and fix them. So, OMG GMO, let me tell y'all. So if you follow me on Facebook, you've been seeing some things. Let me tell you something. When I tell you your girl's trying to change her life around, I am trying to change my life around every day. I promise you, God is amazing, y'all. I gotta say God is amazing because he is guiding me through this thing. Like, for real, for real. So remember I said we were going to talk about the different categories of a lady and characteristics of a lady and the characteristics of a man. We're not there yet. I have not had time to sit down and really discuss that. But this is still your time to find out, are you a girl, a woman, or a lady? Are you a boy, a man, or a gentleman? All of them are different categories and all of them mean something different. So, as y'all know, my book is out, and I know I just totally jumped from the characteristics thing, but they all mean something different, and I want y'all to check into them before I really, really go deep into the different characteristics, so you'll understand the difference where you are. But I'm just going to brush you up on my life right now because I need you to understand that when I say, oh my gosh, he is amazing. God is amazing. So I wrote the book. I told y'all about the book, lulu.com, lulu.com, L-U-L-U.com. Go get the book, The Bounce Back Process, Life After Being Broken. So that has been my journey, talking about that book, advertising that book, getting that book out there, but yet talking about my life. And I do motivational speaking and everything. And I know I'm new to this platform world, so I don't have a whole lot of followers. So tell people about me, like, comment, and subscribe. But keep in mind that this is pillow talk, no judgment zone. I can get a little crazy sometimes, and we're trying to do a set so we can bring people in. So it just won't be my opinion. It'll be the opinion of others. How do I feel about that? Absolutely amazing, because other people got opinions besides mine, and other people feel some type of way about different topics. So I want to come real and upfront to let people know that we are everyday people. If you follow me on my Facebook page, Nikisha Bryant, N-I-K-I-S-H-A, Bryant, B-R-Y-A-N-T, you will know my life is very transparent, very transparent. And this segment tonight is just really going to be motivation, really inspiration, because I have to be transparent on my pillow talk because it's a no judgment zone. And I can get more in depth into things on pillow talk. Well, let's sit up. Let me sit up on pillow talk. You know, sometimes you be in the bed, you got to sit up. So, you know, my hair braided because today I had parent teacher conference. So I braided my little hair and then I just pinned this back up so your girl can lay down and relax in bed. I'm bad. I don't really tie my hair up because I don't like my hair being tied up and confined. So, you know, forgive me if y'all be like, girl, you got to put a scarf on your head. I don't like my hair being confined. My head being confined. You tie your head up, you know, I don't like doing it. I be trying, but I don't like doing it. But, okay, real talk. Pillow talk is a no judgment zone. We come in, we be transparent and stuff. So I get to be transparent with y'all. catch y'all up on some things in my life. So, I told y'all, I don't have... Edit that out. So, I don't have everything that I want. And I don't have the big fancy house. I stay in a duplex. Like, for real. As I grow, y'all gonna grow. And let me tell you something. God have you doing things when you don't have a lot. And God have you doing things when you have a lot. But it's one of those things of, if you're faithful over the few, he'll make you ruler over many. I'm being faithful over the few. Because I have been unfaithful over the few. Yeah. My mom was handicapped when I was 12. I took care of her because I was a hustler. I hustle. And I get in depth about things I used to do. Because you can't charge me for them twice. They can't charge you twice. They might can charge you once, but they can't charge you twice. So I can talk about the things that I've done in my life, let me tell you. But I just want to say, as I grow and y'all watch me grow, just know that what God does in my life, he'll do it in your life. And as y'all grow, tell me about the miracles and the blessings that God is doing, because he is a blessing God right now. He is blessing me. Oh my gosh. So I'm going to put it down below. But I want y'all to know that I have really been going through this emotional battle of learning the new life, learning the new walk. You know, when you're so used to being in control and you so used to doing things your way and you so used to being the boss calling the shots, because that's how your life been designed. And just so happened, whatever your hand touch, it has prospered. Temporary. You got to be real. It has prospered temporary because it temporarily got you where you needed to be. But it didn't keep you. You feel me? Like I hustle. It got me temporarily to certain positions. It did not keep me there. And I'm just yarning now because I've been on the phone the whole time. I ain't been yarning. I've been looking up stuff online. I ain't been yarning. Now I want to come and talk and do my pillow talk. I'm yarning. This is some foolishness. The devil is alive. We're going to do this pillow talk. But yeah, it's one of those things where I was used to being in control of my own life. I called the shots. I woke up in the morning. I went to work. I went to school. And then I went to work again. I came home. I took care of my mother. And then my mother put me out when I was 17. And when she put me out, she was like, two grown women can't stay in the same house. And I was looking like, but you're handicapped. How the heck do you put a girl out that's helping you? My mother understood that I had been grown for so long that she wanted me to go live my life. But I couldn't live my life because I couldn't let nobody take care of my mama. I couldn't let nobody mistreat my mama. I wasn't finna have it. So for a year, I stayed away from my mama for a year. I didn't talk to my mama for a whole year. I missed that lady. And I promise you, after a year was up, I was at her doorstep crying. I took my mom to the fair and we went to dinner and I treated my mom and I loved on my mom, because for a year of not going talking to my mom because I was so called mad at her and angry with her because she put me out, I understood, because I had to grow up. Life made me grow up so fast that I had to go out there in the world and catch up with the personality that I had and the traits and the characteristics that I had. I had to go into the world and experience the world, and she knew had I stayed with her, I wouldn't have experienced it. So with that being said, she put me out. She said two grown women can't stay in the same house. And I wasn't grown. I was 17. I couldn't even get my own place to stay. But she had faith enough to know that what she had instilled in me through the conversations and through the raising of me, even though life had took a turn for her, she still raised me. She knew that she had equipped me for the world. So I had to go out there and catch up with what she had equipped me for, because being at her house, I was probably getting rude and disrespectful, you know, being real, talking like I'm grown, acting like I'm grown. I'm bathing you. I'm taking care of you. Like, for real, y'all, when your mother gets When your mother becomes disabled and no longer can bathe herself, feed herself, wash herself, and you doing all that, somewhere in your mindset, you start thinking you grown because the roles done flip. You feel me? And then I started paying bills. Like, I was working at 13 at Winn-Dixie because I'm from Florida. Duval County. Yes, Duval. Duval. Yeah, so had that moment. But yeah, when you working at that age and you bringing in money and you paying bills, and I mean, I wasn't just 13 years old. Let me tell you, I shouldn't have been working. They should call child labor law. I don't care, but I was getting it in. My checks was $200-$300, and I was getting. Y'all know I was making money. If I'm making $200-$300, and we were getting paid every week, that mean I was putting in some hours. I was really a hustler. I was a go-getter. I go to school, leave school, go to work, come home, take care of my mama, go to school, go to work, leave home. That was my routine. Then I did hair on the side. On the days they didn't work me, I did hair. So I was making the bill money. dropping money on her. My mama taught me how to manage the account. My mama taught me how to get my life together. My mama taught me how to pay my bills and do all that. She taught me all that. She taught me how to manage a bank account and how to manage a checkbook. I had good credit until I got married. Let me tell you, now I'm rebuilding my credit. Let me tell y'all something. It ain't nothing like being able to walk in the bank and they be like, well, Miss Brian, what you want today? I be like, ah! I know what it feels like. I know what it feels like. I go sign up for a loan. I used to sign up for a loan. And then they be like, well, Miss Brian, how much you want? What's my limit? Miss Brian, you ain't got no limit. Whatever you want, we will give it to you with a low interest rate. Are you kidding me? So, you know, your girl working hard to get her credit back the way it was. Let me tell you something. Took one repo to get my credit down. One. Then I voluntarily turned in a car because they didn't keep the warranty up. If you don't have to buy a car from the buy here, pay here lot, don't buy a car from a buy here, pay here lot. They don't keep their warranties. If they change their name and their business company, the next company, and they be the same company, they just change their name. Let me tell you something. When a company say they name changing and new management, they lying. They ain't doing nothing but went around the block, got their little cousin to come up there and sit at the front desk to act like they a whole new company, y'all the same freaking company. Okay, sometimes the companies be done changing, you know? But majority of the time, no. Be the same, own the same company, just change the name because that company went bankrupt. So let me get another EIN number and another account and make changes. I'm a businesswoman. I learned it. So, mind you, go back and get over that. But I came to just tell y'all, everybody got a story. Everybody got something that keeps them in this box. Get out the box. So what you did it, so what you messed up, so what you made a mistake, God said you got another chance. And I'm not trying to be holier than thou, but I'm trying to say God is real. I'm going to drop y'all a picture because God showed me this weekend when I was cooking on my grill. Yeah, I can cook. I'm going to drop y'all some food too. When I was cooking on my grill, I just asked God. I said, God, I just need to know that you with me. I need to know that I'm on the right path because right now, learning this new life and walking this new path, working this one job and leaning independent on you, and I'm casting all my cares on you, and you told me to cast all my cares on you, everything that makes me happy, makes me sad, everything I care about, cast it on you. I cast it all on you. And I just needed to know if God was with me. Y'all, let me tell you something. God showed up and showed out. Remember I told y'all, I'm growing and you be faithful in a little bit, you make your rule over many. Well, my rent needed to be paid. Like, this is November. Rent is due by the 5th. I didn't pay my rent yet. Well, I paid it now. By the time y'all see this, I paid my rent this Monday. 17th, I think. Yeah, I think it was the 17th. I paid my rent Monday. But what the kicker is, I ask God to show me that he's with me, making sure I'm on the right path. And when I tell y'all, I lit my grill, set on fire, I caught the picture of the angel carrying the body. So when you see the picture, you'll see the angel clear and you'll see the body as they lifting the body over the smoke, Oh my gosh, it was so amazing. I was like, God, you are with me. Then he sent confirmation twice more times. He sent confirmation that he was with me. So y'all, trust and believe in God. Because my rent got paid Monday. I woke up, I had extra bands in my account. How? God. I didn't know. I bust out crying Monday. So I want y'all to be encouraged. Anybody that see this live, recording, whatever, because I did a live, then I did a recording. This is my pillow talk. No judgment zone. Because somebody need a no judgment zone. Drop y'all comments and y'all questions below. Topics, we'll talk about all of it. Tell me what you think. Tell me how you feel. But I want to tell you, believe in God. Be encouraged. He is faithful if you just trust him. He asked me would I trust him again. Like he came to me in a dream, y'all. I had done given up on life. I still walk into a building that's called Contagious Hair and Nails and Barber Lounge. They ain't took that building from me. And if they take it from me, it ain't going to dictate who I am. But right now, they ain't took it from me. And what God told me was, I bless you with that. So if I blessed you with that, can't no man take that from you. Because I blessed you with that. So if he blessed me and I can't destroy that blessing, how much more do y'all think y'all are going to destroy y'all blessing? He blessed you. You are a blessed man and woman of God. You are a blessed nation. When God blesses his own. And when he blessed his, when I tell you, the blessings surpass all understanding. Your mouth be like, ah, right, for real, for real. Your mouth be like, ah, because you be shocked. And you got to understand that God is blessing you, like, for real, for real. I don't do these pillow talks because I want to. I do these pillow talks because God dropped it in my heart to do these pillow talks. So whoever going to watch the pillow talks is going to watch the pillow talks and take it in and be able to be a better person. That's all I want you to do. Be a better person. Love you. Cherish you. Fall in love with you and then fall in love with God. As you fall in love with you, I hope you know you falling in love with God because God say, I am you. You are me. I'm in you. You are in me. Ain't he powerful? Killing two birds with one stone. Loving yourself, you learning how to love God. Treating yourself right, you learning how to treat God. So what, you can't see God. Every time you look in the mirror, God say, you are made in my image, just like me in my likeness of my energy. So you are made in his image. So if you made in his image and you look just like him, that means God got many faces, but never change faces. Like I said, he got many faces, but never change faces. You got to know how to know and know what to do when you get them. You got to be real. God is on point. God loves you. I want you to know I love you. Keep it real. Keep it true. We're going to have a part two to this, but understanding that you are important. You are major and you are a blessing. Don't let anybody tell you anything else. You are amazing. You are worthy. You are awesome. Keep listening and be true to thine own self. Live out your purpose. If you don't know what your purpose is, look for your purpose. God will let you know what your purpose is. Whatever that thing is that make your heart flutter. Make you think twice about it. Make you smile when you think about it. That's your purpose. That ain't sex. Let me just make that clear. It ain't that man around the corner on the block. It ain't that girl down the street on the corner that's getting your attention, that's making your heart say, brr, brr. No, no, no. I'm talking about that for real flutter. I'm talking about that real stadium love, like you ready to announce it to the world that I do this. That's your passion. I understand. That's your passion. Go for it. Don't be ashamed. Be true to God. And be true to thine own self. He with you. No, he with you. He got you. He will keep you covered and protected. And after a while, we won't be in my bed doing pillow talk no more. Pillow talk. Oh, pillow talk. Oh, pillow talk. Pillow talk. Pillow talk. No judgment zone. Share your dreams with God. Invite them into your life. Share your heart with God. Invite them into your life. Keep them close. Keep them near. Keep them dear. keep them in your heart. Because if you want to change, that's the only way you're going to get to change, man. Allow God to be God. Allow God to do his thing. Allow God to make changes on your behalf. For you. Because if you allow God to make changes on your behalf for you, you open up the world of magnificent. Look, it ain't coming out right. You open up a world to nice blessings. To a world of blessings that you could never imagine. Oh my gosh, wonderful and amazing. That word, magnificent. There we go. Probably still said it wrong. I told y'all I'm smart, but I talk retarded, let me tell you. But yeah, you open up a whole world of amazing, amazing things. Live, love, and learn. Be true. Be real. Stand on something. Believe in something. And if you don't believe in something, you're going to fall for everything. I'm telling you now. You don't want that. So be encouraged. Stay strong. I know. Y'all don't be wanting to stay strong sometimes. You get weak. I feel you. I got weak sometimes. You gotta stay strong. So, be true to yourself. I'm about to catch a nap because I gotta get up in the morning. Enjoy, be blessed, and be safe out there on your journey and living to finding your destiny. For God is with you. Peace, love, and a sound mind. They told you that you couldn't do it because you washed up. Ain't like them bad girls said you should get your sauce up. But I got this plan and you might not understand. I'ma go hard as I can and I'm gonna be the boss of it. Just watch me do this, put no limits, only swag on it. Walk right up to the front.